Hello, comic fans. Here's Earl Grey. One thing that I enjoy even more than I've initially thought is the whole connecting thing with other freaks, comic freaks elsewhere. Last example for that occasion is a channel called For the Love of Comics. I wrote in the commentary, "Hey, it's unbelievable that I've never discovered your great content before because it's right up my alley and his videos are perfectly produced and so on." And he wrote back, "Great honor to get a commentary from you because I like your panelogies as well." So nice stuff that is going on here, I think, enriches my life. And especially the stuff that has arrived here in the last couple of weeks from you out there with comics done by you and art scenes and whatnot. And I want to show you the last wave that arrived here at Grey Mansion. These are in no particular order whatsoever, but why not start with that amazing cover here, done by a guy from Dublin, Ireland, Oisin Roche. And there's so much stuff going on here, and it's still very decorative. Published by Rogue Comics, they have these other two publications going on here, Ocean City and Nosferatu, a combination of World War II Nazis and vampires. Not very original, but the line Nosferatu really makes me want to have that. I don't have to point it out to you. I think that this here is a straightforward homage to the old EC comics. I mean, magazine sized. We have the narrator guy framing the stories, and even the table of contents has this classic EC format, which is fantastic. And you can go on Oisin Roche's website, oisinroche.com, and you will see that he's a really professional artist with fantastic art, very atmospheric, and yeah, lots to discover there. And in this magazine, of course, as well. He sports this 19th century art with very much sense for bright, contrasting bright and dark parts in a panel with all these hatchings and cross hatchings, but with a really modern edge to it. The stories are told mainly through caption boxes, which is fine, I think, because it fits the template of the EC comics as well. But you have to guess a bit more about the stories in general because you're not getting everything as spoon-fed as in the old EC comics, which I liked about the EC comics, but I like this approach as well. Especially here, this adaptation of Edgar Poe, Allan Poe's Silence is almost like a poem where you can, a visual poem, so to speak, where it has these two layers and you have to figure out how the connections are. A bit more straightforward is this story here, The Midnight Sun, about some conquerors on the lookout for the Temple of Solomon. And there's this lady here. She's a bit uglier drawn than on the cover. I think for obvious reasons, maybe. Fantastic stuff. I really like this atmospheric artistry approach that you don't see too much in modern comics. Often it's very more about to clear everything up until it's so clean that it has lost sometimes any edge or every edge. Ah, come on, focus. This is really kind of art where you see the effort that went in each and every panel. In the back matter, we have bit more blown up. art from him. Cool stuff, hey? He has sent me this much more smaller comic as well, and this is another approach, because this story here, which is an adaptation of a short story, The Troll, by one T.H. Weitz, or is he? Yeah, T.H. Weitz. And here the story is told through scribbles and almost doodles in some cases, but they do the trick, and I really enjoyed the story as well. So now, to change a bit the origin of the stuff that I was getting, here is some stuff from Berlin, from a guy with some American background, I guess. Everett Glenn sent me this album, European album sized book here, square bound, published by Floating World Comics, so I think you won't have any problem to get this book here. And here is Everett Glenn in all his slim coolness. We had some exchange, I think maybe some year ago, about his art. He gave me some link and I commented on how his art, here's some doodle from him and some nice words, which is very nice. And I commented on how his semi-anthropomorphic style reminded me loosely of Rich Tomaso's Spy Seal, just a bit. Which I really love as well. And I really like Unsmooth issue one here as well, but for different reasons, because when you read the stories, these stories here, it's a couple of short stories, then you see that it's really some other approach. This is far more, I think, autobiographical, which is a bit problematic, because these are gangster stories and he's the coolest gangster of them all, or he's a bit insecure, whatever. But he's a criminal in these stories, so I hope he stays clean. Fun stories, the first year is over after two pages, but as short stories go, this is totally there, and everything's fine. The more you read, you see that this is more pondering about his life situation as an artist, how to survive in this world where artists don't make the big money and maybe crimes are the only solution. So the heist here, or the hit that is portrayed when Everett and his gang visits some other gang and they shoot at each other, it's almost the backdrop for these biographical ponderings. Where should I go from here? So you see here, a lot of stuff is happening here. But really, what makes this here even more enjoyable for me and interesting are these comments on our today's society. You wouldn't expect that if you look at these colorful pictures and pages. And he has really a cool Lin Yiclair style. And this is actually just a one pager. I'm really curious what's next up in line for Mr. Everett Glenn. Now to two guys who took obviously part in the Inktober event, some kind of assignment where you have to do one drawing each day of October, and they used their drawings for different purposes. For an instance, Rolando Rodriguez, you can find him and his amazing art and in color as well on this page here, did this amazing zine, Inktober zine. It's a very poignant commentary on city development and city planning in general, Because he imagines this town of or city of Loretta sometimes in the not so far future, and he draws some details of the city and some overviews as well, and writes some commentary to that. And the combination of text and pictures is really what makes this booklet here so great. That I even may use this in my school lessons, school subjects in geography. The city of Loretta's neighborhood of circular buildings, clusters of humanity meant to create unity and social interactions, led instead to dystopian panopticonic community. Yeah. It's all there, the false hopes of these guys who think how people will live in their buildings, and they won't ever build live in their buildings as they have planned. Or here, legend, this is some bitter comment as well. Intended to be an iconic collection of dynamic buildings, the prison towers of downtown Loretta instead are uninhabitable nightmares. Those legendary exquisite corpses of a time when form was valued over everything else. This was, in a cynical way, great joy to read, because it really makes more than just one good point about our today's cities and their very probable future. No, at last, but absolutely not at least, let's talk about these two issues of Cosmic Slop done by one guy from Ireland, Jordan Barry Brown. Let's look at this title here. This is some kind of title. And showcases just at the top of the page here already what an amount of effort and fun went into the creation of this book here. Combining a lot of stuff that you may not have necessarily thought together as a unit, as maybe rap music and Grace Jones and 2001 Space Odyssey, and it's revealed what's behind this monolith. It's a sci-fi story about these pirates preparing and doing a hit, but somehow they got the wrong dudes. These dudes are real cool floaties, somehow Run DMC in as comic book characters, I don't know. Great use of panel layouts. Here's a great example, and here we can see what's behind the monolith. So I think spoilers alert. I should have said this before, but here you can't see it really. But when we turn the page, so now you're warned. These are shelves and stacks of old vinyl albums. And looks a bit like Möbius, but what does not look like Möbius when it's cool comics? And here I love it how it's portrayed when here are the space pirates, and they try to land in their mouth, and here we have the opposite perspective, and there's a record player, some old record player where you put on that great black discs, you know. I want to show you here. After a while, the name of their ship is revealed, Slave to the Rhythm, and quite fittingly, on the next page, we have some kind of space iteration of Grace Jones. Great fun all over. This is really, yeah, already a favorite comic of mine, I have to say. Thinking about it, I don't know why I haven't included in my last video with the favorite comics book series, even though it's just issue one out. I'm excited to get issue two, and you should get these cosmic slops as well. Just Google for Ilstrips. Here, that's the publisher. They have a little page and where you can order these books and T-shirts and whatnot. They have a real merchandise of shop rolling. So Jordan seems to do this really professional. Cosmic Slop here, the Iltober zine. This is printed on heavy cardboard. You can hear me flip through these pages. And these are character sketches he has done for Inktober in preparing issue 2, as he said in the foreground and in the foreword. And I'm really curious to read the story about these strange characters here. And please, 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 let me read the story where the blue bearded sex tourist, maybe eventually a real gross one, but yeah, this one keeps me chuckling every time I can see him here. So Jordan Barry Brown is really up to something. I can't speak highly enough of the stuff here, and I'm pretty sure that we will hear much more of him. He has a great future before him, I think, in Comic Wonderland, as it is true for all the others, of course, as well. I'm pretty sure these are not the last comics or art books that you have seen from them. So I'm really honored that I could showcase these here in this little video. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.